Welcome to the tutorial for the zigzag puff stitch. I'm going to teach you how to create this beautiful, soft, and textured crochet stitch that almost looks like braids. Start by chaining a multiple of 2 stitches, then add 3 extra stitches. Do those chains loosely, then double crochet into the 4th chain from the hook. Then you're going to make a puff in the chain before the double crochet. So yarn over and pull up your loop from the chain before the double crochet. Yarn over and pull up a loop again from the same stitch and repeat another time. Yarn over and pull up a loop from the same stitch. This is a puff with 3 pull-ups, and then yarn over and go through all loops on the hook, and then chain 1. So we have 3 stitches, a double crochet, a puff, and a chain. Then skip 1 stitch. Notice how that was the one you did the double crochet in. Then skip 1 stitch and do a double crochet in the next stitch. Then do a puff in the skipped stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop, yarn over and pull up a loop from the same stitch, yarn over and pull up a loop from the same stitch, yarn over and pull through all loops on the hook, then chain 1. This is how it looks after you've done 2 puffs. And you're going to repeat that across the row, so skip 1 stitch and double crochet into the next stitch. Yarn over and pull up a loop from the skipped stitch and do a full puff into that stitch, pulling up a loop 3 times. Then yarn over and pull through all loops on the hook and chain 1. Repeat across the row, and I'm going to show you how you do a double crochet in the last stitch at the end of the row. And this is how it looks after 1 full row. And this is a setup row, so it's row 2 you're going to repeat when you continue to work. So chain 2, counting as the first stitch. Then do a double crochet into the chain from the previous row. Then puff into the space between the last puff you made and the double crochet you made at the end of the row. So yarn over, work into the space and pull up a loop. Pull up a loop from the same space again, and pull up a loop from the same space again, creating that first puff. Then yarn over and pull through all loops on the hook, chain 1, and then double crochet into the chain from the previous row. Then do the puff in the space between the 2 puffs you made. And this is what you're going to repeat across the row, finishing up that puff, pulling up 3 times and doing a chain. And this is how it looks after 2 puffs on row 2. Repeating that, working that double crochet into the chain from the previous row, then the puff in the space between the 2 puffs. Repeat that until you finish row 2. At this point, we've done a double crochet in the chain, then doing the final puff. Chain chain one and then double crochet into the last stitch. Then all you have to do is repeat row 2 until your project is finished. And you can see that it looks just as good on both sides, so you can use it in any project. Thank you so much for watching this Draw Motion Crochet tutorial. Have a nice day.